Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Kathy. Today I'm just going to be doing a quick video. I'm getting ready for a retreat that I'm hosting in a little bit over a month, and then I'm making Christmas presents, so I'm quite busy right now with some paper crafting projects that I'm doing that I will be showing videos of later, but I'm having less time to kind of make stuff that I can specifically show on YouTube. So today I just wanted to take a break from some of the work that I've been doing, and I wanted to show you my first Filofax that I got. Now I saw a video from one of the scrapbooking women that I'd like to watch her YouTube video, so I'm going to link her video below, but I hadn't even heard of Filofax to be honest with you. And so I saw her video, she got one of the small ones, I think it was one of the pocket ones, and I just watched her video and I was totally hooked. I think I spent that weekend watching hours and hours of YouTube videos on Filofaxes, and I couldn't wait to get my first one. So I did have some problems with my first Filofax. I really wanted the raspberry Finsbury. Well, actually, I really wanted the Imperial Purple, the Finchley, but that one's been discontinued and it's really hard to find. I can't imagine that I'm going to be able to get that one. But so then I wanted the Finsbury, the raspberry one, and they were out of stock for so long, and then finally Filofax USA got them in, and I ordered one through one of the stores in my city that I live in, and they didn't get it to my huge disappointment. So it was on the order, they should have got it, and they didn't get it. So they had this one in stock, and this is the original purple. It's kind of like patent leather. So I like this one as well, and I know that I eventually probably would have bought this one. It's just not the first one that I wanted to get, but such is life, and so this is it. And actually, my favorite color is purple, so I really actually quite enjoy this color purple. But like I said, I was just hoping to get the other one first. So I am still trying to get my hands on the other one, but in the meantime, I've got this one, so I'm pretty happy to get started. So this is the A5 size, which is kind of works for my life. And the reason I kind of wanted to get a Filofax was because I have so many ideas for scrapbooking and for YouTube and for Close to My Heart, which I'm a consultant for, and I just needed to get the ideas out of my head and in one place, because I was forgetting things, like I was thinking of things, but if I didn't have one place to write it down, I was forgetting it. So I really wanted the Filofax for that, and then plus the diary pages, like just planning workshops that I'm doing or retreats that I'm going to or hosting myself. So I'm so excited. And when I think about it, I had, I used a diary in university and I really liked it. And I don't know why I got away from it after I stopped going to university. But I think it's such a great idea to use for your day-to-day life. So I'm going to just show you, this is not how I plan to, this is really just an initial kind of setup that I've done. So I'm going to be adding a lot more detail into this Filofax, but I just thought I'd show you what I've done so far. So this first zipper page has some kind of post-it notes by Teresa Collins, and my current week that I'm doing, I use some of the Teresa Collins washi tape, so these kind of coordinate with that. So I just leave them in the front for when I want to put them in. So this is just a flyleaf. I plan on decorating this as well, probably with some blingy items. And then this is really why I wanted the Finsbury. This color in here is very much close to the Finsbury. So I wanted to use this paper pack, which is called Laughing Lola from Close to My Heart. It's one of the new paper packs that we came up with, and I'm gonna talk a lot about it because I just love it. So I had this in mind for my page dividers. Now, this is solid cardstock, pattern paper cardstock, but I don't find it to be, I want it to be a bit more, more sturdy, but I don't want to, I don't want to laminate these because I want to actually decorate them, the front of the pages. So I think what I'm going to do is either put some chipboard behind it and then put another piece of paper over it just to create some more sturdiness, thickness to it, or I might just double up on the paper. So I haven't decided. So basically I just have the dividers, and this one I used one of the label makers, and it just went, just this one just says monthly. So I really haven't filled in. There's a lot of information I can start filling in, but I haven't actually filled that in yet. These are all the papers you get for like the different measurements and stuff. So what I did is I also couldn't find the 2013, both the diary pages for the rest of the year, the ones that I like, and also the monthly pages. So I just printed these from Filofaxy blog. So I'm so happy that I found that. So this is basically just September and October. I got a purse charm, a twilight purse charm. So I kind of like this. This is just what's inside of it. So I just kind of use this as my page finder, basically, for the monthly pages. So that's what that is. And then, yeah, I haven't actually filled in a lot of this yet, but there's a lot of stuff going on in October for me, so this will be quite full. And then I haven't decorated November and December yet. So, and then this is the 2014 calendar pages, so I'll be decorating these as I go along. And then I also printed out the year in review. I kind of like this to be able to just look at it for reference when I'm planning out things like either workshops or vacation and stuff like that. So I just wanted to print that. So the next tab is my weekly tab. And so what I did is I did print the pages from Filofaxy Blogspot, like I said. And I really like the week on two pages, but I like the blank ones so that I can stamp them myself, the where I write my tasks and stuff. And then but when you buy these Filofaxes, they come with the column week on two pages, but that doesn't really work for me because I don't need it to write in appointments all day long. I just want it for like all the stuff I have to do, and I always have a ton of stuff to do. So one of the things I also found is I have so many stamp sets from Close to My Heart that are clear, which is awesome. And we have a lot of, over the years I've collected a lot of calendar type ones. So I have quite a few, like this one, I love this one. It says important, and I can actually stamp it right over the date so that it kind of stands out on my page, which I really love. So I'm gonna get a lot of use out of those stamps that I haven't used a lot up until now. So this was the first week of school for the kids, so I again pulled out my Close to My Heart stamps, and I have some school kids and the school bus and the apple. So I've acquired quite a bit of washi tape so that I can sort of decorate my pages. So that's been a lot. It's been a lot of fun. This is I actually had these old stickers, if you can believe it. These are Creative Memory stickers. I've had probably, I would say, at least 8 years. And I pulled them out, and they kind of match this page. So I'm also rediscovering some of my old product that I've had. This is the week of the 16th. This is Teresa Collins. I don't know which one it is, but she has these washi tape sets that you can get. So I use that on this page. And these are some of the this is actually one of the, I use this one a lot, this stamp set. This is going to come in so handy for my Filofax because it has all the different versions of lines that I can use. And then it's got some of these, I don't know what you call those, the little boxes so you can check off whether you've done it or not. So I actually, this is my kind of go-to stamp set that I use when I'm first decorating my week pages to put my lines on it. So I'm quite enjoying that. And on this page, I was kind of fooling around with, you know, a lot of times I line up my lines, but this time I was sort of alternating them just to see what I liked, if I liked it. And I have to say, I'm not sure if I'm crazy about that or not. But so the week after, which is last week, I went back to just having them all on the same row or whatever. So, and then this is my clear ruler. So this is today. I have quite a bit of stuff that I've been doing this weekend. And then I've started to decorate next week. After this video, I'm going to be stamping my lines in here and then starting to write out. And what I've found is I don't actually like making the pages a week at a time, like for instance on the Sunday for the following week, because I just find I have so much stuff that I need to remember that I need the weeks ahead to be kind of done so I can write stuff in, because I'm reluctant to write on the pages ahead because I don't know what color pen I'm going to be using. So in this case, I'm going to be stamping out today probably the next 3 weeks or so of pages. So I just started decorating them just with the washi tape, but I'm going to be actually stamping them today so that I can start writing out. I have a lot to do between now and I'm hosting a scrapbooking retreat in November, so I have a ton of work to do between now and mid-November. So I need to write notes, I need to write out to-dos basically in order to get everything ready. I've in order to get everything ready for that. Plus I have some Christmas gifts that I'm making right now and I have to get them ready for October. So I have a lot to do. Anyway, so this is just a quick video. And then this is, okay, so after the weekly pages, I have what I'm calling beauty. I have a lot of, I watch a lot of beauty gurus on YouTube, which I really enjoy just in my downtime. So I wanted to have a place where I could write out lists of things that I wanted to look at in the stores and consider purchasing. So this is kind of my beauty tab. So I have all the different things. And the other thing I'm going to list here is when I buy something, I don't want to buy duplicates of it. So this is where I can track, for instance, I really like Zoya nail polishes. So I can track my nail polishes that I have so that I don't buy doubles. So I just, this lined paper I got from basically this workbook that I got from Target, and I just pulled the pages out and then cut them down to fit the Filofax. So YouTube, this is going to be my ideas for videos that I want to do. And again, even though I put this together, I haven't even had a chance to write this stuff out. So that's how busy I've been. But anyways, it's there and I'm going to start working on that. Then I have my close to my heart and my blog kind of tab. So this is where I'm starting to plan out my retreat project. So I started taking notes of what I need to cut on the Cricut and that sort of thing. These are some stickies that I have that I'm going to transfer the information from here onto my lined paper. And then this is going to be lists, like probably to-dos, other things I want to do around the house and that sort of thing. And then it goes right into my address kind of tabs, which again I haven't filled out. Now for this I'm probably going to put a lot of my customers' names and addresses for close to my heart. And then I'll probably, I don't know, I might put in some personal ones too, but I am going to use this for business, my business contacts mostly. So, and in the back I just started putting, I have the business, I think it's the business card holder or the credit card holder, I'm not sure, they're a little bit different, but I bought one of those, and then I have an extra zipper, and I'm going to be putting in here, this is one of the kind of things that I want to use to decorate one of my tabs. So I'm going to be doing quite a bit of decorating, so it's going to be going to look really nice when I'm done with it. And I'll probably do another video of a more detailed setup of my Filofax, but right now this is how as far as I've gotten started. And then I also have to decide what I'm going to put in here and in these little tabs, little pockets there. So I hope that you enjoyed this video, and yeah, be sure to check back for other Filofax videos that I'm going to be doing. I'm going to definitely be doing one on a more detailed Filofax, but I'm also going to show you some of my storage that I've started. You really need to figure out your storage when you're getting a Filofax and you're going to be decorating it, because you accumulate quite a bit of stuff. So I will be showing you that, and the pens and stuff that I really like so far. This one is the Friction pen, which is an erasable gel pen. So I've been really enjoying these. So thank you so much for watching, and I'll link below that original video that kind of got me hooked on the Filofaxes. And then there's been a few people that post quite a few videos on Filofax. So, I've started following them and sort of getting ideas here and there from them. So thank you so much for watching, and until next time, bye-bye.